Hey, happy Friday, everybody. Quick recap for the week as we are heading into the Memorial Day weekend. Some happy news. Today is National Wine Day. So if you are a wine drinker, be sure to take advantage of that in case you weren't aware. 50 years ago yesterday, the Rolling Stones released Jumpin' Jack Flash. So hard to imagine that's been 50 years. So pretty cool. The song is still a freaking awesome song. Had a really great week of the Money Savage podcasts. On Monday, we had Dr. Carolyn McClanahan. So she is a actual medical doctor who became a certified financial planner. And so we talked about the interplay between your actual physical health and your financial situation. So it was a great conversation. On Wednesday, we talked with Marv Feldman, who is the executive director of lifehappens.org. And that's a nonprofit that tries to get the word out about having proper coverage, specifically life insurance, disability insurance, and long-term care. So Marv's an industry veteran. He's actually the son of Ben Feldman. And if you're not aware of who Ben Feldman is, and it'd be weird if you were, he is the most famous life insurance salesman ever. He was a New York life agent, and literally one person, Ben Feldman, would sell more than an entire company put together on an annual basis. So anyway, it's kind of cool to talk to his son, who again has been in the business for 40 or 50 years. So great conversation. And then on Thursday, it's always a bummer of a topic talking about divorce, but talk to Sarah Davison, who is a divorce professional in the United Kingdom. So kind of cool to expand the podcast beyond the United States and over to England. So had a great conversation about getting past divorce, moving past that, and how, even though it's a terrible experience, it can actually go on to be a very empowering, kind of a jumping off point for the rest of your life. So check that out. I read in the news also a couple of things that are not quite so exciting as National Wine Day. I read that college tuition was expected to double by 2036. And my wife and I have an 18-month-old. His name is James. So effectively that means that college is going to be twice as expensive when it's time for James to go to college. So kind of a bummer, but it is what it is. So, and then finally, I read about how the average annual percentage rate on credit cards hit the highest number that it ever has hit at 16.73%. So if you have credit cards and if your credit cards have balance that rolls over from one month to the next, meaning that you're not paying off the credit card on a monthly basis, that's something you need to address immediately because you're getting hammered by interest rates. And I don't know if you're aware of that or not. I guess maybe the first piece of advice that I would give you is find out exactly what the average or the annual percentage rate on those cards is, and then really endeavor to get those cards paid off. I appreciate that a lot of people out there prefer to pay with credit cards versus a debit card for a variety of reasons. Number one is if you use a debit card and as soon as you swipe that, the money actually leaves your bank account versus if it's a credit card, then the money's not actually leaving your bank. So you're using somebody else's money, and there's also benefits of points or miles or things like that. So if you are using credit cards responsibly, meaning you're paying it off on a monthly basis, that's great. Continue to do that. But if you're not, you're getting crushed, 16.73%. And that's just the average. So there's some credit cards that are way higher than that, and hopefully there's a lot that are lower, but that's how averages work. So anyway, hope you guys had a great week. Hope you got great plans for Memorial Day weekend. Get out there and hopefully enjoy some good weather. Drive safe if you're hitting the road. And be grateful for everyone that fought and lost their lives for the freedoms that we enjoy today. So we'll talk to you next week.